You may have heard two New Mexico lakes were closed late this summer because of blue-green algae blooms, which can make people and pets sick. It's finally cooler outside, and as summer swim season wraps up, we wanted to understand more about the risks from exposure to the blooms and why this is happening for the first time in some of New Mexico's lakes. In this month's episode of Our Land, correspondent Laura Paskus travels to Abiquiu and Cochiti to find out more.
On August 13th, as the high temperature in Albuquerque climbed above normal to 94 degrees, the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers closed Abiquiu Lake to swimming and other recreational activities. 9 days later, it closed Cochiti Lake.
Cyanobacteria, or well, we know them as blue-green algae. Technically, they're not algae. They're actually a bacteria that can photosynthesize, so they can harvest light from the sun, like plants and trees and grasses and shrubs. They live in the water. Generally, they're microscopic, so you can have 50 of them on a head of a pin. And they're naturally in lakes and rivers and streams and ponds as part of the green part of the food web. So check it out. All of this is this cyanobacteria that's blooming.
Becky Bixby is a professor at the University of New Mexico's biology department. She's also associate director of the Water Resources Program, and she studies algae for a living. Low water levels, high temperatures, and long sunny days, of which New Mexico has had plenty of this year, all help trigger these blooms. Runoff from farm fields and ranch lands and upstream pollution are factors, too. A combination of these can cause certain species of cyanobacteria to grow and quickly multiply. Their cells form these blooms in slow-moving waters, like lakes and ponds, and then the blooms can create toxins. John Mueller is the operations project manager at Abiquiu Lake, which is on the Chama River.
Most algaes are not harmful, but what we're seeing up here and what we have tested with higher toxicity levels is a lime green, kind of like pea soup color. If you see that type of formation or film on the water, avoid it. Avoid contact with it. Don't let your pets swim in it. Keep your kids out of it. And come tell a park ranger so we can kind of get an understanding of if this is a new area and if what we need to key into. But the biggest thing is just if you see that, stay out of the water.
Touching the algae can leave rashes or blisters on your skin. Swallowing it can cause stomach problems. Breathing droplets, like when water skiing or swimming, can also lead to hay fever-like symptoms. And the toxins can even cause liver or neurological problems. And for dogs, who gulp lots of water when they swim or lick the algae off their coats, exposure can be fatal. Not only that, when the blooms die off and decay, they use up the oxygen in the water, sometimes triggering fish kills. Mueller and state health officials say they haven't heard reports from people who've gotten sick. And Mueller says they're monitoring the water in the lake and below the dam, where there aren't any signs of the algae.
We do not want to negatively affect people coming up and recreating and enjoying the resource. So we're trying to strike the balance of a good response plan, outreach program to educate the public, but also, if necessary, partial closures. We don't want to do a full closure because that does have an impact. But our main goal and focus is to keep our visitors as healthy as possible.
Above Abiquiu Lake, water in the Chama River is nutrient-rich, with high levels of nitrogen and phosphorus. Because the river moves relatively fast, the blooms aren't a problem there, but that water ends up in the lake. Christopher Barrios is with the New Mexico Environment Department, which regulates pollution and these high nutrient levels.
It can come from point sources like wastewater treatment plants. Also, a large portion comes from runoff from storm events, agriculture runoff from grazed land and irrigation water.
It's not realistic to kill off the bacteria in lakes and reservoirs, especially not across such big areas, and the treatments themselves could kill fish and harm the ecosystem. Instead, the goal is to reduce the nutrients getting into the river. That includes working with the ag and livestock communities to stop so much nitrogen and phosphorus from fertilizers and waste, from getting into streams and rivers in the first place. These blooms are a problem in the Midwest, in the South, even sometimes in southern New Mexico. But what we're seeing at Cochiti and Abiquiu this year is new. As the climate warms and lakes and reservoirs keep dropping, we're going to see more of these blooms in New Mexico. That means facing the challenges isn't just about closing lakes here and there or getting through this summer. The blooms are pointing us toward bigger issues in our state when it comes to water supplies, rising temperatures, and water management.
In some ways, it's interesting because it brings a lot of people with different interests together, a lot of stakeholders together. People who are managing the reservoirs, people who are managing drinking water, people who are interested in the health. And so pulling these people together to solve this problem is really exciting. In a state with a lot of reservoirs, and we're dependent on those reservoirs for various things.
Even up in northern New Mexico, with its relatively cool summers, this won't be the last time New Mexicans see these blooms and lakes. So Bixby says it's important to continue monitoring the water and collecting data on the blooms and why they're happening. She also says it's important that all the agencies and stakeholders stay at the table to think about a statewide plan so we know how to respond to blooms, and especially stop them before they happen. For New Mexico in Focus and Our Land, I'm Laura Paskus.